It's 12 years in a week today. We played our first ever show at the Charters Arms pub in Rotherham, and it's like, couldn't really be any further away from where we are today. And I mean, I've never even been to Royal Albert Hall, and so many people have told me it's like incredible, and it's just like, you know, one of the nicest venues you'll ever see, and it's like breathtaking. I kind of expected to be like underwhelmed just because it'd been built up so much, and when I walked out today, it was just, it's just like, oh my God, this is insane. It just looks so, I don't know, it just looks so prestigious, doesn't it?
It's just impressive, isn't it? This whole place. It's the prestige of the place and just the name alone, you know what I mean? It's quite big in it. Well, it's massive in England and British culture and stuff like that. So, you know, it's pretty mad to think that we did start playing pubs and Birmingham Barfly and that, and now we're here, you know what I mean? I think it's kind of a bit of a testament to how far the band's come, you know what I mean? And where we came from and stuff like that.
It's mad, isn't it?
Paul Ryan, our booking agent, came to us and said, "Oh, we've got this show offer that we've been working on with the Teenage Cancer Trust for the Royal Albert Hall. Why don't you do it with an orchestra or some kind of small orchestra?" I think was what he said. And then went away and just went mental. I was like, went to Will, who's someone who played violin on our album, the guy who's arranged half of this, and he's playing with us tonight. And I sort of said, "Can we? How many players can we get for this budget?" Which was not that much. And he said, "Oh, leave it with me." And he was like, sort of did the rounds and said, like, I reckon we could get away with about, you know, 50-piece orchestra. And I was like, let's do that then.
Yeah. Albert Hall has ever fucking seen. To the left or the right, I don't give a fuck, but you better fucking move. Push it back. Come on! Make us proud! Push it fucking back! Bigger! Bigger! The world has coalesced into one giant mess of hate and unrest, so let's all sing along. I need you to do me a favor. I need you all to fucking jump. 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 Up, 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 up. As you can. I'm from Sheffield, England. And this is fucking mental. Needs to be louder than that. Come on, Yorkshire. We're gonna play you a song we've never played before. Thank you.
Even though you might not realise it, I guess classical music and definitely like the orchestral part has played such a massive part in our band since like There Is a Hell Anyway, you know what I mean? Like ever since Never Ends, strings have been like, yep, we're going to be using them quite a lot now. Like it just almost became like a thing that we're known for, you know what I mean?
How many players do we actually have?
It's just under 50.
Yeah, okay.
So it's like...
Including the choir though.
It's, that brings it up to 60.
Yeah, yeah.
About 60 odd people.
It was actually Ollie who mentioned it to me first. Because he was like, oh yeah, I think, you know, we might do some strings on the tour or something. And then, well, that's what you had been saying. And then Ollie was like, oh no, we're doing this Royal Albert Hall show, we should do something there. And then, like, about 2 weeks later, you said, yeah, that's what we're doing. And do you want to do it? And I was like, yeah, absolutely.
I've been turning... what song did we do?
Shadow Moses.
I've been turning Shadow Moses into a huge orchestral piece of music.
Basically, we're trying to like rather than just like do bits that are on the CD with an orchestra. Simon and Will are kind of trying to like almost like write more parts and take them to a completely different level, so they don't just sound like orchestral versions of the songs. Because
we're trying to make it into a show, aren't we? Like, so there's going to be pieces of music which are written specifically for the show.
Exactly.
Yeah.
this what you call love? This is a war. My God. tears were swallowing me. Mirrors start a whisper, shadows start a sin. My skin swallowing me. So it's 12 years and a week today we played our first ever show at the Charters Arms. This is all for you. Surrender the throne, the blood on my head covers the holes.
This song's called Throne.
Conservatoire of Music and Dance. Today's our first actual rehearsal day, so it's the first time we've got any of the other musicians together to practice, and it's just a choir, so we've got 14 singers, 7 guys and 7 girls. Yeah, so the aim today is basically to try and get through as many of the choral parts as possible, make sure they're all working, and just making sure everyone's got all the right bits and stuff like that, everyone knows what they're doing.
My name's Kat Marsh and I'm the choir leader for the show. It's been amazing. Yeah, it was kind of nerve-wracking, like, building up to it, but having everyone in the room and hearing all the parts, like, live has been incredible. Like, it's made me really excited. I'm looking forward to it.
I think that's right, isn't it? Like, everyone comes in a sing-along, not the solo, that's just...
No, it's just a sing-along.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah, when we got Kat involved, she helped kind of fixed the choir and got in touch with a load of singers who she knew and she thought would be into doing it, because obviously it's for charity, so we're not making any money and we can't really afford to pay people properly, so we're pulling in a lot of favours, and a lot of the singers today are people who kind of wanted to do this because they want to sing in the Royal Albert Hall, or they want to help the charity, or they just want to be involved. So it's kind of like a, yeah, it's cool that everyone's here and helping out sort of thing. And yeah, sparing, using their spare time for the benefit of the charity.
This song's about true friends. Thank yous are in order. I'd like to start with our management, Raw Power, and our booking agent, Paul Ryan, for having this amazing idea. I'd like to thank all the crew, especially our tour manager, Rob, who's gone through hell. I'd like to thank Rosa, who's put this all together. I'd like to thank Will, Simon, Cap, for fucking smashing the hell out of this. Give him a round of fucking applause. Oh, man. This is special, this is fucking, I've never been so fucking nervous in my life. We're gonna slow things down now. Great, good.
Can you feel my heart? On the basis that you don't give a fuck, can you please get your middle fingers up? show's called Antivis. Talk about why we're all here today. We're all here today because of one of the worst diseases man's ever faced. Cancer. But instead of talking about all the devastating things it does, because you all fucking know about that, I want to talk about the one thing you can say that's positive about it, and that it brings us all together. It makes people stronger. It makes people fight. People like Stephen Sutton, who raised millions and millions for cancer when he had a fucking time stamp on his fucking life. My childhood friend Aidan, who's here today, who's just overcome bone cancer. Can you give him a round of applause? He kept his family together. He said, if I die, cancer hasn't won, I've won. I won't let it break my soul. I won't let it break my spirit. How many of us can say we can be like that? It's fucking crazy. This song is for anyone that's battling cancer, that's lost someone to cancer, that's helping someone through cancer. This song's about going through the darkness and coming out on the other side, because we all can do that. Cancer is just a word, it's not a fucking sentence. This song is called Drown.
And I always knew it was going to be cool, but it weren't until like really actually started seeing the orchestra play and stuff that like it's not just an orchestra playing the parts that we've got on our songs. It's like this whole new composition. It's like it sounds like a movie score. It sounds and it seriously does by anyone's standards.
It just adds so much more depth and like new parts to music, and it brings, you know what I mean? It's even though we're playing like new songs and stuff, it makes them, it freshens them up a bit still, you know what I mean?
It's quite emotional. It sounds like a film score. And I remember I was like, I had like a lump in the back of my throat. I looked around and I saw Ollie was like, and I was like, oh, okay.
Jordan were actually weeping, weren't you? Yeah.
It's what? We are Cato Music in Wimbledon, and it's the first day of, well, it's our only day with the orchestra.
Yeah, first time seeing them. Well, it's their first time playing together as well.
Yeah.
So it's quite interesting.
Emotional, unusual day.
Cool. I mean, it was the first time the orchestra was played together as well, so it went pretty well, if you ask me. Sounding cool.
Yeah, it's been great. Orchestra worked really hard. The orchestra sound great. The arrangements work. Everyone seems pretty happy. Everyone seems pretty stoked.
I was nervous, but now I'm not. It sounds good. It's going to be good to do it tomorrow.
Thank you.
This is it. Fucking noise. Thank you so much, good night.